More now on George Papadopoulos, the Trump campaign advisor who pled guilty to lying to the FBI about his contacts with Russians during the campaign. His agreement lays out months of contacts with Russia and top campaign officials. Our chief investigative correspondent, Brian Ross, here with the details. Good morning, Brian.
Well, good morning, George. The Russia investigation now has its first turncoat or whistleblower among the president's men and women. And the question this morning is, who might he bring down? 30-year-old George Papadopoulos has emerged from obscurity with the best evidence yet of possible collusion between the Trump campaign and the Russians.
It was 1 week after the inauguration of the 45th president that campaign advisor George Papadopoulos met with FBI agents and proceeded to deny over and over that he had any dealings with the Russians. Donald Trump himself had consistently denied any connection too, as in this exchange with ABC's Cecilia Vega.
Did you or anyone in your campaign have any contact with Russia leading up to or during the campaign?
Nothing at all.
Not at all, he said. But Papadopoulos knew better and now has admitted he lied to the FBI. That, in fact, shortly after becoming part of the Trump National Security Team, seen in this campaign photo, he met with two suspected Russian agents. And that within a month, the campaign advisor went to London and was offered dirt on Hillary Clinton with thousands of emails by his Russian connections.
Connections that would be involved with crimes that were committed by the Russian government that are designed to help one campaign over the other.
The White House is now claiming Papadopoulos was just an unpaid advisor with a minor role in the campaign.
No activity was ever done in an official capacity on behalf of the campaign in that regard.
Yet, according to the court documents, Papadopoulos reported to four senior campaign officials or advisors who offered encouragement, with one telling him in an email, "Great work."
It was just 6 weeks after Papadopoulos was in touch with his Russian connections that another group of Russians went to Trump Tower and also offered dirt on Hillary to Donald Trump Jr., son-in-law Jared Kushner, and campaign chairman Paul Manafort. Trump Jr. says nothing came of it, but now that meeting, too, is under investigation by the special counsel.
So, Brian, Papadopoulos arrested back in July, and they called him in their plea agreement a proactive cooperator. That suggests he could have been wearing a wire for these last months.
Absolutely. That is a time-tested technique the FBI uses with people like this who are part of an alleged conspiracy to contact those also in the conspiracy to see if they will implicate themselves.
Brian Ross, thanks very much.